we've all got them, we're all using them, and in many cases, we're pretty much just abusing them. The cell phone is one's lifeline. We use them to go online, to email, and of course, to yap our yappers.
I just got a new cell phone. My whole life is in the phone. I'm using it as both an office and personal reasons as well.
Now, there is one cell phone that's in as high demand as that of New York City real estate. It's gotten a lot of attention since coming out this summer. It's the iPhone. And here in New York, people were literally lining up in front of our Mac stores days before it even came out to get their hands on this little gadget, buying as many as they could for their staffs, their friends, and well, it's the well that has company officials here at Apple so concerned that they've implemented a non-cash policy. According to PC World, the company is tracking who purchases the phone via credit or debit card, because buyers are unlocking the phone so they can get on other wireless networks besides AT&T, the phone's exclusive carrier, and reselling the phone.
The purpose of a credit card is to pay for something and to build credit, as opposed to find out what you're doing with your own personal property.
I was one of the people that waited online the first day to get the iPhone. You should be able to do whatever you want with your iPhone once you purchase it. And I don't like the control that they're having.
Nearly 1.4 million iPhones have been sold, but approximately 250,000 of them are spelling trouble for Apple, costing the company millions of dollars in lost revenue. As for me, I'm cutting back. I kind of can't take it anymore. The constant pinging alerting me to my new email on my somewhat antiquated Trio is getting a little old. I mean, we've all got ADD here in New York, and the cell phone isn't helping on that front. So let's get old school. Send me a letter or email me, and I'll get it when I'm at home, with the time to actually focus on your words and respond in a non-frenzied manner. It's a whole new tech world out there, and maybe us New Yorkers can make our noisy little city an eensy bit quieter. I'm Rachel Natalie Klein. See you next time on Into the Box.